Today's the start of 10's pilot showcase, where 6 brand new shows are launched. One of them is Time to Die, which includes some really painful comedy. Mm. It's a show where Australia's top comedians are forced to bomb live on stage.
I've recently had to give up dating people that are not in my league. I struggle with women, and it's because I'm hot and smart. It's genuinely annoying, though, how many women have rejected me that I'm better than. You know? That would never happen to a guy who is dumb, like this guy.
If I could stop, from Time to Die, would you please welcome Jen Fricker and Tom Cashman? How is this audience? They applauded you after that. That's remote. How does a comedian of your standing and stature dish up that?
Well, I mean, that's the format, is that I was forced. I was quite frankly forced to do that. I mean, I wasn't forced to do the show, but the premise of the show is that two comedians write deliberately bad sets for the other comedian and then get to watch and laugh at them while they bomb. It's the kind of thing that sounds very fun to participate in theory. But then when the week comes, you're like, oh, no.
Well, Jen, you're the host of this.
Yes.
And I have to ask, because I just watched that little promo grab there and I'm there moving and squirming in my seat. So is Kate. We're like, oh, God, it's just so awkward. So what is it like to watch that car crash unfold?
I mean, beautiful, life-affirming.
Yeah.
There's a real sense of, like, there but for the grace of God kind of a thing. Ben Russell and I host the show together and we've got little monitors at the back of the venue watching poor Tom go out there and just absolutely eat it. And it's, yeah, honestly, I've watched the show a couple times today already and it gets better every time. And I feel like Tom, the more we talk about it, gets more shell-shocked, like it's coming back.
Oh, no. I've seen the show a few times and I love it. It's such a brilliant original concept. Tom, so you, obviously, we've seen you perform the stuff that Sonia Deloria wrote for you.
Yes.
And then you have to write for her. So yep. What was your strategy when you were writing for Sonia?
Well, this is the problem. I actually made a mistake on this show because it's the first one. I didn't go hard enough. So I thought it would be fun to, because I get quite annoyed when people say how much they love particular foods as if that's a personality. People will often go on about how much they love wine and cheese as if that's interesting.
Yep.
So I thought I'd just write a lot of jokes about cheese and how much Sonia is obsessed with cheese, right? Which was just a bit daggy and a bit lame. And I thought that was the premise of the show.
Yeah.
Sonia's jokes for me made me seem evil. She made me say that I was going to date Margot Robbie. She made me in Melbourne say that lockdown was easy and Sydney was a better city. I was getting booed.
Yeah.
Well, I was completely underestimated.
She fights to the death.
Let's have a look at some of Sonia's cheese-based antics.
I am so single. I am so, so, so single. I'm so single that the company Kraft, you know, the company that make Kraft singles... They're suing me for sneaking into their factory late at night and illegally eating fresh cheese.
Now, I don't know if this is crazy. I maintain that that joke's pretty funny. Am I crazy?
You're in a lot of trauma right now, and I think you're just remembering things.
Clearly, yeah. I get it, yeah.
Was it hard for you to write bad jokes?
No. No, I actually genuinely think it's easy because, like, how you're meant to, I mean, generally speaking, there's different styles of comedy, but generally when you're writing a joke, you come up with a premise, you create expectations, and then the humour is in when you subvert those expectations.
Right.
But writing a bad joke, you just have to create expectations... And leave it there. And disappoint everyone.
Now, Jen, what have the crowd reactions been like?
Honestly, it was a marvel that, like, Tom wasn't run out of the venue that night. Like, and you'll see if you watch the show, you can see as he walks out, there's a man in the audience and he goes, oh, look, it's Tom. I love that guy. and then just watching his face drop and avoid eye contact with other people. Some people look furious. Some people just look disappointed. It's my favourite part. I mean, look, there's so many things I love about the show, but it is one of my favourite parts. It's just this, I mean, we saw it just before, this woman's face just absolutely full of rage.
I mean, Tom, you're flying at the moment. Are you worried? Are you concerned that somebody will see this a snippet of this and write you off? I'm never buying a ticket to see that guy in my life. Yeah. Because the context is important with this.
Particularly in some of the teasers earlier in the show. It was like me performing and then something like, not funny. So, yeah, a little bit. That's the other thing where I kind of got a bit screwed in this, because there's two different venues. So Sonia, the other contestant, she performed in kind of like a groovy bar in Melbourne where people are kind of, you know, everyone's young in the crowd. They're all quite open to experimental performance. I had to perform at like the biggest comedy club in Melbourne. I like more of a suburban audience who's paid more money and expect it to be good and punchline heavy, and they were booing me.
Like Tom's on the defensive now. Yeah, like people haven't even seen it. Maybe it's not that bad. You know what I mean? But yeah, look, it was terrible, and that's
Oh goodness, Jen, you're hosting. Is that so you'll never have to do this yourself?
Yes, of course.
Yeah, of course.
Look at this man. He's unraveled. I'm healthy. I'm happy. I'm loving life. You know what I mean? No. Yeah. They initially when they asked me, I thought they were asking me to perform, and I was like, I guess, sure. Oh, and then God. I can leave straight away. Wonderful. And they were like, you're hosting. I'm like, oh, fine. Oh, great. Yeah.
Good deal. Yeah. Great.
You've got the pick of the jobs.
I really do.
This concept is amazing. 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 Yeah, it's amazing. But for everyone who wants to see it, Time to Die and all the Showcase pilots are streaming right now on 10Play. Guys, thank you so much for stopping by. Jen, you've got the smartest job. Tom, you've got the hardest job. I don't know how you've done it.
Tom, congratulations on your career.
It's been nice.
Show you how to win that way.